money.
Change your bank.
Move your money. Move your money.
I want to debunk this viewpoint that the people down here are unemployed people only, or students, or they're just, you know, completely off the wall. I'm an employed person. I am one of the 99 percenters. I want campaign finance reform, and I'm here to say that we all need to get into this. And it's time now. It's time now to stand up and for what you believe. I have a daughter that has a bachelor's degree, 10 years work experience, has been laid off for 2 years, can't find a job. She's so underemployed right now. And it's time to get out there for our kids, not just for ourselves, but for our kids, and to help support them to get out and say what they need. But it's not about rabble down here. It's not a mob, as some of our politicians would tell us it is. It are responsible people that are looking for change, and change now.
We need to take back San Jose. Night and day, day and night, we're fed up with the corporations abusing the poor. All the foreclosures and all the people that ended up on the street, that's a disgrace to the American people. The mortgage bankers have got to pay their dues, and we're here to make sure they do it. I'll tell you what, we're going to stay here till the cows come home. Please join us. In this effort, we pray that you give us help. We're tired. Some of us are tired. Some of us got sighted. Some of us went to San Francisco. We're staying here in San Jose.
I'm here in San Jose, and we're here to fight for reform in government and corporations, because right now, whether you're a Republican or you're a Democrat, the politicians no longer serve their constituents. So this is just the tip of the iceberg for a movement that has to grow to save our democracy, to save our republic, and to save our nation. So this movement that has now become international, and we are the leaders of the world, us as citizens of the world, we need to make these changes, not only for our nation, but for the nations of the world. So long live this movement of reform. We need this reform.
My husband and I are both small business owner, and we run a small insurance company. And I'd like to dispel the myth of taxes and regulations being a hindrance to our business. Taxes are not a problem for us, and regulations take up very, very little of our time. What's hurting our business right now is that people don't have jobs. They don't have money. They're losing their homes, so we're losing their insurance on their homes. They're not able to buy cars, so they're not increasing their insurance cost. We would love to hire somebody else. We need another staff person to help us with all of the issues that go on in our daily business activities, but we can't because we don't have the money to hire. We keep losing business. It's more and more difficult to gain new customers. We're losing customers rather than gaining customers. We have customers calling us every day to try and find ways to reduce their premiums just to help them get by. So taxes and regulations, it's a fallacy. There is nothing that holds corporations back when it comes to taxes and regulations. I guarantee it. From a small business owner's standpoint, not true.
My name is Henry, and I'm Oak County, San Jose. I've been out here 13 days. It's happening in New York, Washington, D.C., San Francisco. Last Sunday, we have over 300 people now. We probably have around 50 people today. Anybody come here, enjoy, and find out what's going on. You guys can check out on YouTube at www.occupysanjose.org or occupywallstreet.org, and follow us on Facebook and Twitter.
This is what democracy looks like.
My son over here and I have come down here to Occupy San Jose to express our frustration with the way the large financial institutions have corrupted our society and our government, and the damage that they've done to our economy.
I'm here to represent the people that are people like me. There's been some people that have asked me, you know, you're here. I'm sure people would like to see you in a suit, you know, talking to some of the big fish. And I'm here so that other people like me will know that there's us in the crowd too, not just a bunch of suits, not just a bunch of college kids. You know, I never made it out of high school. I barely got any 10th grade. I keep telling people that it's not the 99% that are poor versus the 1% that are rich. It's the 99% that are oppressed by the 1% that oppress us. And where this movement's at right now, I feel, is just us standing up so that people that may have been afraid to stand up by themselves in the past in fear of being alienated will know that there's other people like them that are standing up too, and they can come stand strong with us.
My conscience dictates that I come out because I think it's about time people started waking up to the financial and economic inequities that have just been so rampant in this country, and people haven't been doing anything about them for a while. I remember I saw on Facebook today, Albert Einstein said, it is not so much the people who are doing bad things who will bring this world to an end, it's the people who watch them without doing nothing. And personally, I'm glad to be a part of a movement that's doing something.
Hi, this is Martin. Just here for the second week going now, and we're human beings and we have rights, and according to the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence, we're trying to do the right thing, and the authority is trying to come in and, you know, give tickets. I got a ticket today. Not too happy about that. This morning I got woken up, and I don't want to wake up to them. I was tired, devastated. We're trying hard. We're that 99% and that 1% is always trying to make their way, want their money. They want money. See, you got to understand, there's a lot of us, and I'm not the only hurting one, so you guys should figure it out. Thank you so much. We love you. Come support us.